the noise inside, the sound of angels are, the sound of angels' songs, and all this for a king. We could join and sing, all the Christ the King.
Session, but I guess because I only have one session, that's why, right?
You're awesome.
That's right. Awesome. Who was that? That's right. I guess, you know, people know me.
That's right.
I love to hear that compliment always. Boy. You're awesome. Tell me one more time.
You're better than Joe on.
No, awesome. I'm not. I'm I sing better than my brother. Do you believe that?
Yeah.
Amen. Yes. That's right. In my family, I'm the only one who believes that. All right. Shake your body. Not like dancing and shaking your body, but it was more of a, like a, you know, have you guys seen anybody having a seizure? Yeah. It was more like that. There was foaming in her mouth. So I'm telling you, I didn't know what the heck was going on. I got a little scared, but I'm a pastor. You know, I have to look bold and courageous. So bring her to me. Right? Bring her to me. Demon is behind all this. Oh yeah, demon, you know? I was like, okay. For me to fly over the building, I will fly. I have gift of faith and power. I went up to her. I was the one, I was the very one. Pray for her. There was one phrase that I learned in Spanish. I can speak so fluent, I sound like a amigo, right? Jesus, te ama mucho. You know what that means? That Jesus loves you very much. First gift that I'm going to talk about is a leadership gift, all right? It comes out from 1 Corinthians chapter 12, all right? People, when we go through it, the reason why I'm going through all these definitions one by one is because I want you to think about yourself and recognize this gift. And I thought I had this gift when I was in high school. Right? Not because I was a lonely man. Right? Not because I was a social outcast. Not because I was a wangta. But I just dedicate my life to the Lord. I said, Lord, as long as you use me, I'll be single and tired the rest of my life. And that changed right after I graduated from high school. All right? But this gift, buy yourself a new week. With God, all things are possible. Amen? I believe this. And this one and only. Yeah, I just give some of these verses to you guys, some of you guys. I would not know. I would not know if these are problems that you're going through. My spirit, I know. He has that kind of gift too. Right? He has a gift of confession. Right? So when you're hungry, call him. We'll buy you food. Right? With this gift, you could expose sin or deception in others for the purpose of reconciliation and speak a timely word from God, causing conviction and repentance and edification, and see truth that others often fail to see and challenge them to respond. Every Thursday night, a Thursday after school, I gather people and pray and study Bible. Boy, people hate it. They hated that school, school club. Because no one wants to come and participate. Though you don't understand what you're saying, tears are falling down. And in your heart, you have to start to have this conviction of your sins. Conviction of faith. It's in all things fire, all things fire. God's state, it needs to be happened, and God will give it to you. It will be the love that will heal people, that will edify church, that will discern. Even if you have gift of healing, even if you have gift of power and miracle, if you don't have love for the souls, If you don't have love of Christ in you, all those things will be useless.